Hi, I'm Amanda, and today we're going to go over how to find solutions to inequalities. One second. So when it comes to inequalities, there's a few symbols we have to know. This first one right here is a greater than symbol. So as you can see here, x plus 3 is greater than 2. That's what that means. This one, since it's the opposite, is less than. So here we can see 7x is less than 28. But now we also have this symbol, which is the greater than one, but a line underneath. That means greater than or equal to. So here we have 5 is greater than or equal to x minus 1. And lastly, we have the less than with the line under, which means less than or equal to. So here we have 2y plus 1 is less than or equal to 7. So when we solve some inequalities, our goal is to have x, or whatever the variable may be, on its own side on the left of the inequality sign. So you want something like this over here, where it's x is less than 5, or something like this here, which is y is greater than equal to 11. And that's how you solve an inequality. So here we have the example of x plus 2 is greater than 12. So you would subtract 2 from both sides to get x by itself. And when you do that, you have 2 minus 2, which is 0. And you have 12 minus 2, which is 10. So you get x is greater than or equal to 10. And any number greater than 10 would solve this inequality. Solving inequalities is much like solving equations. We do the same thing, except it's just instead of a number, it's any number greater than or any number less than. We must pay attention to the direction of the inequality. So which way the arrows point? If it's over like this, you have the big number on this side of the little arrow and the small number. See, because there's only 1 and 2, this is just a good way to visualize which way is the bigger side. And you can visualize that on the number side. So if you have an answer that is x is greater than 1, it's any number over here of 1. Or if you have it x is less than 1, it's any number less than 1. So a number line sometimes can be helpful to be a good way to visualize the problem. So we'll do some practice problems with this. So is m equals 8 a solution to the inequality below? So m is greater than 11. So is 8 greater than 11? If you look on the number line, you'll say no. See? Is q equals 11 a solution to the inequality? The inequality is q is less than or equal to 6. Is 11 less than or equal to 6? If you look, no, 11's bigger than 6. Is x equals 8 a solution to the inequality below? We have 5 is less than or equal to x. So if you plug in 8 there, is 8 greater than or equal to 5? And the answer is yes, 8 is bigger than 5. Here, is t equals 1 a solution to the inequality below? It's t is greater than or equal to 2. Is 1 greater than or equal to 2? And the answer is no, it's not. Here we just have, is d equals 6 a solution? And we have 2 is greater than or equal to d. So is 6 greater than or greater than 2? Which is no, 6 is less. So yes. So that is how we solve inequalities. A number line can help, but also remember just greater than or less than. And if you ever get confused, just draw it out on a number line. So yeah.